one of you individuals out there, everything moving is in the hand of the Heavenly Father Yahweh. And who is the hand of the Heavenly Father? Yahawashi. And guess what? This spells bad news for you Old Testament junkies out there, you Old Testament only Israelite groups out there who go on this campaign to cast stones at the throne of our Lord Yahawashi. You know, they push forth this rhetoric of serving Yahawashi is equivalent to serving idols. Well, guess what? You better hope that we wrong. You better hope that what we reading right here is off. Because according to this definition for the word all, in relation to the power that has been given our Lord Yahawashi, well, one of the definitions is everyone. And if that's the case, then this would mean your destiny lies with Yahawashi. See, what you're going to realize, Yahawashi is a very powerful spirit, man. And it's greatly to be feared and reverenced. And that's outlined in the book of Revelation, the 5th chapter, where it tells you how the angels even bowed down before our Lord Yahawashi. See that? Now, with that said, there's a reasoning behind this. There's a reason why our Lord Yahawashi was exalted and given a name or a status above each and every spirit here on the planet Earth and throughout the heavens and beyond. Well, it's based upon his qualities, the way he was designed. You know, you can consider, you know, for an example, the beast of the field. You have certain animals that was designed to survive in harsh conditions. Let's say, for an example, the desert. Whereas you might not survive in those conditions where you have certain animals that was built and designed to thrive in that inhabitant. See that? Well, you can apply that with our Lord Yahawashi. He was given certain qualities to solidify his position, man. That's what we're going to highlight in this lesson, if you will. All right? Which brings me right here